Hi, hello friends, welcome to World Explorer India. Today on May 8, we are celebrating World Migratory Bird Day. Theme of the year 2021 is Sing, Fly, Soar Like a Bird. Today this video is giving you the information about the migratory birds in India and some of the bird watching techniques which I am going to explain to you. You can see these are the pictures taken by me in Lakota Talao, Jamnagar, Gujarat, where you can see the birds like flamingos, gulls, pelicans, spoonbills, which are coming and as a migrant, and many of the tourists come here to see these migrant birds. And again, this is Sukhna Lake in Chandigarh, Punjab, where you can find out many of the migratory birds in the months of November to March. These birds come from Siberia and China. Birds are the glorified reptiles with the feathers. Birds fly to escape from the dangers. So this May 8 World Migratory Bird Day theme is Sing, Fly, Soar Like a Bird. The study of birds is called as ornithology, and the one who studies about the birds is called as ornithologist. India is a wonderful place for the water birds, because India has food, water and breeding places for these birds, so many of the birds are migrating to the India. Migration is to and fro from the breeding grounds. Europe and North Asia is in summer, their birds are going to stay there, but whereas in autumn, this Europe and North Asia, the environment is not going to be suitable for these birds, so they want to shift to the South Asia in autumn season because of the warm tropical conditions to escape from the freezing conditions in the Europe and North Asia in winter season. So usually we see the migratory birds from August to December in India, return to Eurasia in the months of March. During the migration, some of the birds molt, that is shed the older feathers and grow the new ones, which is helpful for them for flying to the larger distances. Some of the birds molt completely before the migration, some even in between during the migration also they may do. Before going to the migration, these birds feed excessively to develop the reserve fats in their body. If they are traveling for a long distances, they need lot of energy, so they develop the reserve fats in the body. They move according to the winds. If there is a favorable wind, they move, and you can see the birds forming the V shape in the sky. Here the one which is very knowledgeable about the roots and the one which is very stronger in the group will be at the front, and they form the V shape because this will help to save the energy while migration during flying. The flyways usually seen here: Central Asian Indian flyway and East Asian Australian flyway. Ducks, geese and cranes are the common migratory birds which we see in India. Migrations exceed greater than 500 kilometers if you see the birds like ducks and Arctic shorebirds. If there is no fat, then these birds are going to perish. Some of the migrating birds stop over sites en route. So if you are able to identify where the birds are stopping over, if we are able to feed them properly, they can have some energy to migrate, and there is less chance of extinction of these birds. So these stopover sites help in conservation of the migratory birds. Molting in the birds, shedding of feathers causes decreased insulation, so they may need more energy. Nowadays Satellite tracking is also being done by telemetry. Here they are using PTT, that is platform transmitter terminals attached to the birds. It is limited to the birds weighing more than 1 kg. And there is one more technique, this is called as bird ringing. Here it is an ornithology tool. This is helpful in identifying the bird routes and resting areas. And also this will help in identifying the age patterns of the birds based on the wing size they are going to see and based on the molting. And even this will help in identifying the population studies of the birds. A qualified professional ornithologist knows how to identify as a male and female bird, and also they can determine the age based on the wing patterns. And again, this will help in identifying the birds which are, and also we can differentiate the birds like migrants which are partial migrants or long distance migrants, passes or winter migrant species, etc. And also this will help in identifying the average life expectancy of the birds. What exactly bird ringing is? Putting a numbered ring on the leg of a bird, and this is a unique number which can help in identifying the bird, and also we can measure the wing length to identify the age of the bird, and even they record the weight of the bird and they set the bird free. In India, these are the areas where you can see the migrant birds. In Jammu Kashmir, there are three sites: Ular Lake, Surinsar, Mansar Lake, Hokera Wetland. In Punjab, you can see six sites, and in Kerala, three sites. And in Himachal Pradesh, Assam, West Bengal, Bihar, Andhra Pradesh, in Kolleru Lake, Manipur, Loktak Lake, Maharashtra, Lonar Lake, in UP, you can see 8 number of sites, that is Nawabganj Bird Sanctuary, and again Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary is most famous. So these are all the areas where you can find the migratory birds in India. So if you want to see bar-headed geese, you have to visit the Pong Lake Wildlife Sanctuary. And greater flamingos can be found at Nal Sarovar Bird Sanctuary, Pulicat Lake. Blue throats from Alaska can be found in Rajasthan. Siberian crane found in Bharatpur. Emu falcons seen in Doyang Lake, Nagaland. And to celebrate this, in India we are celebrating bird festivals, usually conducted by Okhla Bird Life Sanctuary, Chilka Bird Life Sanctuary, Goa, Karnataka, Punjab, etc. So bird watching is a recreational activity or a hobby. If this is a hobby without investment we are developing, so bird watching is getting popular nowadays. What is exactly bird watching is identification of the birds. If you are able to identify the name of a bird, or if you are able to identify the feature of a bird, then you can enjoy this hobby. So you should be able to identify the bird habits, habitats, and how the seasons, in the season, in which season, which type of bird you can see. And also you can identify the flight patterns, etc. So what exactly you need is binocular, telescope, notebook, pencil, census data sets, etc. And you may be need to consult an experienced ornithologist. And also if you are able to see in fields, there are migratory birds coming and sitting at one place. So if you are able to identify, or if you are able to count the number of birds, you can even identify that whether the bird count is increasing or decreasing in such area. Usually the birds can be found at lakes, rills, water bodies, etc. And you know that migratory patterns vary from different types of birds. Some migrate during the morning and some migrate during the night, etc. So bird photography is very good if you are having zoom lenses up to 1000 nanometer focal length. And videography, if you want to get a stable videography, you need a tripod. So even in India, we are developing tourism for bird watchings, like Chilka Lake in Orissa, Nal Sarovar Bird Sanctuary, Ahmedabad, Gujarat, Pulicat Lake in Andhra Pradesh, Sundarbans National Park, West Bengal, Kumarkom Bird Sanctuary, Kerala, Eagle Nest Wildlife Sanctuary, Arunachal Pradesh, Bharatpur Bird Sanctuary, Rajasthan, Salim Ali Bird Sanctuary, Goa, Sultanpur Bird Sanctuary, Haryana, Rangatittu Bird Sanctuary, Karnataka, Vedanthangal Bird Sanctuary, Tamil Nadu. So these are the places where you can identify the migratory birds. The problems for bird conservation is include wetlands converted to agriculture and increasing use of the agrochemicals and avian flu. This year we have seen many of the birds die because of avian flu at the Pong Wildlife Sanctuary. So for more information, you can visit indiabirds.com, birdlife.org, Geological Survey of India, Wildlife Institute of India, and a very good resource, Arun Kumar Handbook on Indian Wetland Birds and Their Conservation. If you like this, do subscribe and share to your friends and family members. Thank you.